Green.
Ready to begin your fabulous shopping spree?
You sound like a game show host.
That's the correct answer. Well done. Ladies and gentlemen, should we tell the lucky contestant what fabulous prize she's won?
Sure. Okay.
Right this way, please. Let's take a look at your fabulous prize.
Bring me some milk fruits for sleeping, and there'll be caps in your pocket. Off you go, then.
Welcome to Grey Garden, darling. This is the Commonwealth's first and only hydroponics facility, run entirely by robots.
That's pretty ingenious. I bet you can work around the clock.
Never seen anything like this.
Of course, darling. Our unique hierarchy allows for constant operation. You see, there are two kinds of robots here. The worker drones carry out labor and maintenance. We supervisors, that is myself, green and brown, possess sophisticated cognition processors. We are capable of complex analysis and decision-making, a testament to the genius of our creator, Dr. Edward Gray.
What became of Dr. Gray?
Like so many others, he died in the war. It was a terrible loss. Robotics and artificial intelligence were our creator's great passions, rivaled only by his love of television. Perhaps you've noticed that I possess a rather singular personality, as do the other supervisors.
This took a weird turn.
Well, it's definitely unique. Sort of hard to miss.
I'll take that as a compliment, darling. After all, the last thing any woman wants to be is ordinary. A few other things you should know. Talk to Green if you need supplies. If it's caps you require, Brown might have a few odd jobs. There's one other thing. The question, really. Tell me, darling, what do you think of the water around here?
The water?
Oh, it's ghastly. That's what it is. Simply ghastly. Pressure is down. Radiation is up. Why, it's practically toxic. Just think what it must be doing to my skin. This will never do. I don't mean to impose, darling, but perhaps you could lend us a hand.
All right.
Marvelous. Simply marvelous. Most of our water comes from the old Western plant, south of here. Such an eyesore. Be a dear and pay a visit, hmm? See what you can do. Maybe tidy up the place. It must be filthy. If you can get it working again, I'm sure I can come up with something for you.
automated message repeating. This is Scribe Halen of Reconnaissance Squad Gladius to any unit in transmission range. Authorization ARCS, Ferrum 9-5. Our unit has sustained casualties, and we're running low on supplies. We're requesting support or evac from our position at Cambridge Police Station. Automated message repeating. This is Scribe Halen of Reconnaissance Squad Gladius to any unit in transmission range. Authorization ARCS, Ferrum 9-5. Our unit has sustained casualties, and we're running low on supplies. We're requesting support or evac from our position at Cambridge Police Station.
They aren't gonna need that anymore.
Our unit has sustained casualties, and we're running low on supplies. We're requesting support or evac from our position.
This place.
sweet.
Sorry about it. Just point me to it.
Thank you. try anything, and I'll cut you down.
We appreciate the assistance, civilian, but what's your business here?
I'm just trying to survive out here, like everyone else.
The way you charged in and engaged those ferals, I find that a bit difficult to believe. Are you from a local settlement?
I'm from Sanctuary Hills, on the other side of Concord.
I've seen the location on our maps, but I've never visited the area myself. There isn't much over there for us to collect. If I appear suspicious, it's because our mission here has been difficult. Since the moment we arrived in the Commonwealth, we've been constantly under fire. If you want to continue pitching in, we could use an extra gun on our side.
I want to help, but I don't like the secrecy. Who are you really?
Seems more than reasonable, if you really want our help.
Very well. I'm Paladin Dance, Brotherhood of Steel. Over there is Scribe Halen and Knight Reese. We're on recon duty, but I'm down a man and our supplies are running low. I've been trying to send a distress call to my superiors, but the signal's too weak to reach them.
Sir, if I may...
Proceed, Halen.
I've modified the radio tower on the roof of the police station, but I'm afraid it just isn't enough. What we need is something that will boost the signal.
Our target is ArcJet Systems, and it contains the technology we need, the deep-range transmitter. We infiltrate the facility, secure the transmitter, and bring it back here. So what do you say? You willing to lend the Brotherhood of Steel a hand?
No time to waste. Let's get moving.
Outstanding. Halen, take Reese inside and bind his wounds.
Yes, sir.
Reese, once you're on your feet, I want you to make certain the perimeter is secure.
I'm on it.
All right, civilian. It's time to prove your worth. Head into the police station and resupply yourself. Then let me know when you're ready to begin. Let's move out, people.
All right, big guy. Let's go.
You've got your reasons, but that just looks like junk to me.
So you gonna patch me up or what?
I don't know. Your prognosis looks pretty grim. It might be more humane to just take you out.
Field Scribe Halen, personal log entry 324A. I'm starting to wonder if joining the Brotherhood of Steel was a good choice. I originally signed up seeking protection and comradeship, but I'm worried that I've traded away a bit of my humanity in the process. The Brotherhood's message of hope for the future is idealistic and noble, but their methods leave a lot to be desired. The leadership seems especially misguided. Instead of diplomacy, they wield violent confrontation to exert control. Despite all that, I've been successfully avoiding the fighting by following the career path of a field scribe. I suppose only time will tell how long I can stand the sight of spilled blood over my own moral fiber.
Team, Captain Widmark here. Welcome to the task force. Operation Winter's End starts now, with you. Together, we will knock Eddie Winter off his throne and dump his sorry ass in a 2,000-volt easy chair. It should come as a surprise to no one that our operations in Boston have been, in a word, compromised. Winter has eyes everywhere, even the BPD. So, our brothers across the river in Cambridge have been kind enough to let us use the Cambridge Police Department as our base of operations. Let's get to work. Good hunting.
Paladin Dance.
You ready to move out?
Ready.
Outstanding. Follow me, and try not to lag behind.
Why are you standing around here like there's nothing to do? Paladin Dance is waiting for you.
Jet is a short hike to the west. If we take this road, we should be able to avoid the larger packs of ferals infesting Cambridge. Traveling this far from the police station is a risk, but getting that transmitter up and running needs to be our top priority. If it was up to me, I'd relocate my team. But Scribe Halen detected some disturbing energy readings in the area that need to be investigated. We don't know much about them, except that they're short-lived and broadcast on a frequency only attainable with a high level of technology. Whoever or whatever is creating those energy readings might be a potential threat. So it's our job to investigate. Setbacks, I don't intend to give up and head home. Or end up missing. Jet systems. There shouldn't be any exterior security, so we'll head in through the front.
Hey,
Dance.
Listen up. We do this clean and quiet. No heroics and by the book. Understood?
Why are we at ArcJet again?
We're here to retrieve a device that will boost the signal from the radio tower at the Cambridge police station. Without it, we can't make contact with our superiors. Remember, our primary target is the deep range transmitter. Stay focused and check your fire. I don't want to be hit by stray bullets.
Excuse me, Paladin Dance.
Look at these wrecks. It appears as though the facility's automated security's already been dealt with.
Good. Less security to worry about.
Negative. There's nothing good about it. Look at the evidence. There isn't a single spent ammunition casing or drop of blood in sight. These robots were assaulted by Institute synths.
Synth. Isn't that the same as robot?
They're an abuse of technology created by the Institute. Abominations meant to improve upon humanity. It's unacceptable. They simply can't be allowed to exist.
What's the Institute?
They're a group of scientists who went underground when the Great War started. Spent the last few decades littering the Commonwealth with their technological nightmares.
I'll be on the lookout.
Roger that. Let's move out.
Okay.
Watch your footing. Looks like the power's out in this section. Look at this place. Scribes would have a field day in here. The transmitter should be in the control room at the top of the core, but it looks like the elevators are dead. We'll have to keep heading down for now and find a way to get the facility's power back online. There has to be a power backup system somewhere. Scout the maintenance area off of the main chamber. I'll remain here. watch our backs.
Sweet.
Mind that you can do that.
There we go.
Engine core power restored. Thermal engine fueled, primed, and standing by for your command.
Stealth capabilities.
Command accepted. Commencing 5-second countdown. 5. 4. 3. Completed with an efficiency rating of 96.7%.
Oh my god! Are you alright?
Got cooked by those flames. But thanks to my power armor, I'm still in one piece. The important thing is that we're still alive. We have a way to get to the transmitter.
Let's go.
Thank you. Hey.
What do you need? Sure. Here's my supply.
Paladin.
Keep the noise down. This place is crawling with hostiles. Well, that could have gone smoother, but mission accomplished.
Smoother? I thought we did fine.
That sweep was sloppy. We were caught unprepared more than once, which is unacceptable. However, your extra gun gave us the edge we needed. I'm not certain I could have accomplished the mission alone.
I thought we worked well as a team.
Agreed. It's a refreshing change to work with a civilian who can follow orders properly. That being said, I believe we have two important matters to discuss. First and foremost, if you'll hand me the deep-range transmitter, I'd like to compensate you for your assistance during this operation. I think you'll find this weapon useful. It's my own personal modification of the standard Brotherhood laser rifle. May it serve you well in battle.
Thank you.
You're welcome, civilian. Now, as far as the second matter goes, I wanted to make you a proposal. We had a lot thrown at us back there. Our op could have ended in disaster, but you kept your cool and handled it like a soldier. There's no doubt in my mind that you've got what it takes. The way I see it, you've got a choice. You could spend the rest of your life wandering from place to place, trading an extra hand for a meager reward. Or you could join the Brotherhood of Steel and make your mark on the world. So, what do you say?
I don't know.
I know the Brotherhood has all the fancy toys, but don't forget about your responsibility to lead the Minutemen.
It's a big decision, so I understand your hesitation. If you decide you want to become one of us, you know where we are. Good luck.
Hi.
Did the Minutemen send you?
Yes, I'm here to help. What's going on?
There's a group of raiders that won't leave us alone. Stealing our food and supplies. Threatening us if we can't give them what they want. We know where they're coming from, but we can't stand up to them ourselves.
Don't worry. I'll take care of those raiders for you.
I hope so. We didn't know what to do.
Thank you. time, boogeyman.
When we first met, I admit, I had my doubts about you, but you've done nothing but impress me. You're just who the Minutemen needed to bring us back from the brink.
Thanks. That means a lot coming from you.
You've probably realized by now how important the Minutemen are to me. When I was a kid, the Minutemen were my heroes. They were the only good guys around, really. When I turned 17, I joined up with Ezra Hollis's company. He was one of the good ones. Really believed in the old-time Minuteman way. We had a few good years there. I felt like I was part of something bigger than me, like I was really helping make the Commonwealth a better place.
If things were so great back then, how did it all fall apart so fast?
I'm sure there was a lot I didn't see or know enough to pay attention to. You know, the politics and rivalries and bad blood between the different groups. I guess General Becker was able to keep a lid on it. Keep everyone more or less on the same team. But after he was killed, it all came out in the open. I couldn't believe it at first. These guys were supposed to be Minutemen. They were supposed to put their duty to the people ahead of everything else. You probably think I was pretty naive, huh? I guess I was. Still am, too. Even after everything, I still believe that the Minutemen can be what I always thought they were. The good guys.
Why are you telling me all of this?
I guess I'm just trying to say thank you, if that makes any sense. Thank you for being different than most everyone else I've run across. Anyway, I appreciate you taking the time to listen.
Anytime, Preston.
Thanks. We probably better get back to it.
Hey.
Point it out.
None of them now.
I don't like it. Hey, let's go eat. I'm starving. You can eat when I'm damn sure we're not about to get jumped.
You're dead!
Bullshit.
Thank you.
What was...
Yes.
never know. There's something useful in here.
Sweet.
Some of this might be useful.
Did you have any luck with those raiders?
I took care of those raiders for you.
Really? Well, that's the best news I've heard in a long time. By the way, we've talked about it, and we've decided to support the Minutemen. I think it's worth giving it another chance. The only way things will get better is if we stand together. Heads up.
What is it? This is what I've got.
Having trouble sleeping? Tell me stories going on about the instincts of bothering people in your life. I just couldn't sleep with all that stuff on my mind. You should have a drink before bed.